The city of Zaporizhya lies in the southeast of Ukraine along the Dnieper River. It's very close to the front lines and so far remains in Ukrainian hands. In the early days of the war, fighting at its nuclear power plant put the entire world on edge. Now things have settled down there somewhat, but Zaporizhya has become a way station for thousands trying to escape Russian attacks. Special correspondent Volodymyr Solohub is there for us.
Zaporizhya is relatively calm now, but the routine here is anything but routine. The city has become a major logistics center for those fleeing the war in Mariupol and other towns in southeast of Ukraine.
We have evacuated around 112,000 people to central and western parts of Ukraine since the beginning of the war. We serve as a sort of layover hub. If all those evacuees stayed here, and that's tens and hundreds of thousands of people, it would be very difficult for the city. Most of the evacuees just stay here overnight and keep going into central and western Ukraine.
This is the city's main layover hub. All those fleeing the horrors of war come to this processing center to get help moving further from the fighting. And you can see the damage on the cars arriving here. Victoria was forced to live 3 weeks in a basement of an apartment building in Mariupol with her six-year-old daughter, Yelizaveta, and two elderly parents. She told us of the daily struggle to even cook.
We would put a pot on a fire outdoors, add some water, start cooking. When they would start bombing, we would run back into our basement, then come back to see if it's ready. A lot of young guys helped us with whatever they could. Before the war, you would call that looting. Now it's just some help.
Staying in Mariupol was, of course, very dangerous, but fleeing the city was both dangerous and uncertain, since they didn't have internet access, and hence the outside world.
On March 19th, when we were watching our apartment burn, we realized we needed to leave. But we couldn't leave our neighborhood, we were too afraid. Some people left at 4 a.m., packed their cars and drove. Some didn't make it and were turned back. There were no evacuation buses whatsoever.
And while the worst is behind Victoria and her family, their future is uncertain. As she walks into this welcome center, she says she's not really sure what's next for her.
For many, the road from Mariupol and other besieged cities in eastern Ukraine took days before finally reaching this parking lot of a hardware store on the outskirts of Zaporizhya. And inside, they can get some clothing for those who had very little time to pack before fleeing the war. And here, they're being greeted by the volunteers and social workers. They can get some food and hot drinks, and for the first time, feel some sort of normality.
They arrive here with children, pets, and the few belongings they could take with them. Many are confused, frightened, and not sure what to do next. But all of them ask the same question. Why did this happen to their city?
One of the main problems of Mariupol, according to both the experts and those who fled the city, is the absence of air defense systems. If they had a proper air defense, Russians wouldn't be dropping 1,000-pound bombs on civilian objects. And Zaporizhya also needs a proper air defense system. This will protect both our civilian objects and chemical plants and other dangerous facilities.
We discussed the need for more air defense systems with a Ukrainian fighter jet pilot. His location, face, and real name could not be disclosed. He asked us to refer to him by his call sign, Juice.
Right now we need some Soviet systems from our allies, like S-300 Buk system, which are mastered by our crews. Every day we are using our systems. Russians are hunting our SAMs, our ground-air missiles, so every day we need more and more and more. We need to close the sky about our cities, about large infrastructure, like nuclear power stations, etc.
How big of a game-changer that would be if Ukraine was to receive these types of weapons?
We have a lot of advantages in land forces. We have a lot of good tanks, anti-tank missile systems, and other systems on the ground. But in the air, unfortunately, we are not able to fight efficiently.
And while Ukraine is waiting for more air defense systems, people from Mariupol and other towns and cities in southeastern Ukraine continue living the horrors of war, whether in the basements of their homes or making the death-defying journey to safety. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Volodymyr Solohub in Zaporizhia, Ukraine.
And a note, our coverage of the war in Ukraine is supported in partnership with the Pulitzer Center.